Hi guys, welcome back. Today I'm going to be recreating my most popular video where I tell you how to go from cold and dark to ready for takeoff in the A320 family in Flightgear. So without further ado, let's get started. When you first start up the simulation, you'll be met with this menu screen right here. We're going to open our aircraft config and we're going to make sure our ADRs align instantly. Make sure that box is checked. We're now going to load our cold and dark panel state. So the plane is completely off, completely cold and dark. So now what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to look up towards your main top panel and turn on your batteries. And then we're going to go to our APU here and we're going to press on the master switch and the start switch. Now you're going to have to wait for them to start up. While you're waiting for them to start up, we can look down here. And what we're going to do is we're going to turn on our radios with these buttons, here and here. So now you basically just have to wait for our APU to start. I'm going to skip until the APU has started. Okay, so we're back. Our APU now says avail, which means we're ready to move on to the next step. We're going to turn these all on. And now we're going to turn on our ADRs. Now, if we hadn't checked that checkbox earlier, this step would take a little while. But now, because we've got that checkbox turned on, it all aligns immediately. We are now going to push back our aircraft by going to Utilities and Push Back. We're going to enter a route, so enter. And we can now mark on the ground where we want to go. So I want to go out to here, ready to taxi, so I'm going to place a point there. I'm going to make this point sharp, which means it's going to make a sharp turn. We can do that by clicking on the sharp button. And there we go. We've got a sharp turn at there, and this should basically be done. So we're going to click done. That's going to enter our route. We're now going to click connect the pushback. We're going to release our brakes by pressing shift B or pressing on this down here. Shift B or pressing on there. Now we can click auto push and click start. And you can see we're going to start moving. So now that the pushback is complete, we've got to start our engines. So to do that, we're going to make sure our APU bleed is turned on. And then we should be able to change this switch here to ignition start and just turn them both on. And then we should see our engines are now turning on. So we just have to wait for our engines to fully turn on. Okay, so now our engines have started, we can set up our computer. So I am flying to London Heathrow from London Gatwick. So we can go to our radio and program our ILS frequency to Heathrow's ILS frequency. So once we put in that, we can also go to our takeoff. Here it is, takeoff. And I'm just going to set these numbers to what works for me. These probably aren't correct and are very wrong. So if you would like to do your own research, then be my guest, because these are almost certainly incorrect. So now we've got our computer programmed, we can finally start taxiing to our runway. So to do that, we're going to use our engines. I'm going to connect my joystick right now. So now I've done that, we can now release the parking brake and we can just use our engines to move us forwards. So now that we've taxied onto our runway, the next steps are pretty easy. We're going to set our flaps to a takeoff configuration, arm our spoilers in case we have to abort. We're going to turn our auto brake to max for the same reason. If you care, you can turn on the seatbelts and no smoking signs. So, after that, now you're pretty much ready to take off. You can set your autopilot if you need to the correct settings. So, once you've done that, you're just going to fully You're just going to set your throttle to full and make sure your parking brake is released. You're now just going to keep going down the runway until you reach an appropriate takeoff speed, like which is around 150 to 160 knots in my from my testing, works just about fine. Once you reach your takeoff speed, you're going to pull up so your aircraft nose pitches up. You can now pull up your landing gear using the lever or the G key on your keyboard. And you can disarm your speed brake and put your flaps to zero. So that's how to take off and set up your aircraft ready for takeoff. The next video I create will be on landing using the ILS system. Stay tuned for that. That should be out relatively soon. If you have any other ideas or requests that you would like to see from me, then please leave them in the comments. I'll try to facilitate creating them. Until then, I'll see you again next time. Bye.